Welcome to Guns, Chicken Strips. I'm your host, James. What's happening? Today's going to be my answer portion of my Q&A. I got all your questions, which you amazing viewers put in the comments from yesterday's video, and I'm going to answer all of them, or all that I can anyway. Please don't mind my voice. I've been a little sick the last couple days, but I'm getting over it. And this weekend's going to be glorious. So I hope you enjoy this video. I'm going to try to answer every single one of your questions that I deem reasonable anyway. So let's get to it. Going full America on you. This is actually my chillin' suit. American flag hat, American flag shirt. Camera on a tripod on my computer. Cell phone to get the comments. So here we go. Enjoy. Let's see. We're gonna start from the beginning. Go from number one. A lot of comments. First question comes from Atchafalaya Outdoors. How long have you had your YouTube channel? Well, I uploaded my first YouTube video at Demolition Ranch in September. So I believe it was September 17th. I just couldn't pass it up down there with Matt and Rob from Lunkers TV, Matt from Demolition Ranch. Couldn't pass it up, man. Ever since then, it's been hardcore grinding and working. Do not let anyone tell you YouTubing is easy. Trying to have a successful one anyway. And I'm still not even considered a YouTuber, man. I don't even consider you a real YouTuber until you have over 100,000 subscribers. So I'm nowhere near that. I'm still just making videos. I love it though. It's a lot of fun. You guys are the reason it's a lot of fun. Next question. Next one. Since you've met Mr. Demolition Ranch, Matt, what would you rate Matt in the scale of coolness when you guys are behind camera? Matt Carricker, Demolition Ranch, 100% great guy. Exactly who you see on the screen. He is the man. Such a great guy. Great dad, great father, great husband. Exactly who you see in the videos. There's one genuine dude right there. When we were down there, nothing but courtesy, nothing but respect, everything about him. Good homegrown Texas dude, 100% genuine guy. This one comes from Rogel. What inspired you to start doing YouTube, and have you reviewed the original chicken and rice? No, I have not reviewed the original chicken and rice. I do not know what that is, but I'll definitely check it out. What inspired me to do YouTube is Rob from Lunkers TV. He's been pushing me ever since he started his channel to start one. He says, Jimmy, you're a creative punk. Get yourself a YouTube channel and we'll make this happen. Finally, he convinced me. I did it. And it's been going great ever since. I love it. Kaysen Cannon. Do you like to fish and why don't you use a bait caster? I love to fish. I actually bought my first boat when I was 16, called the Shoddy Boom Bot. That thing was awesome. No, 17. That's the boat me and Rob used to go out on all the time, not even knowing how to fish or where to fish or what. We just love to go out and cast out there. And why don't you use a bait caster? Well, because I started off using spinning combos, and that's what I got used to, and that's what I fell in love with. And I just never really liked the whole weight on the top of the rod. I liked the weight on the bottom. It just balanced out. I never really got that serious into fishing. So I just did it for fun. So I did what I was comfortable with, which is spinner combo. But you'll see in the future videos, I'm going to really start hardcore working on using a bait caster. Because after Rob pretty much forced me to use it in the last couple fishing videos, I really like it. Casts a lot further, a lot smoother. So be prepared for some bait caster learning. Kaden Dima. Next question. Kaden Dima. Favorite firearm of all time? My favorite firearm of all time. That's an impossible question, my brother. Impossible. They're all bad to the bone. I'll tell you what. I'll give you three that I love the most. Yeah, three. Got a 1911, a Glock, and an M1 like my SOCOM. So there you go. 1911, M1 like my SOCOM. The fourth question is from Jake N. See him a lot in the comments. Good viewer. Commenting a lot. Hitting that like button. One of the bomb diggities. Do you know what 12 cubic feet of hard red wheat weighs? I'm going to guess that's some sort of trick question or play on words to make me sound dumb. But no, honestly, I even Googled it earlier. Didn't even find an answer. So no, I don't. All right. Dylan Whitaker. Hey man, I'm also a fellow Texan. Do you plan on quitting your real job to do full-time YouTube like Mr. Turkola and the other Googans? Yes, 100% if I ever reach that level, but it's going to take a lot of work and help from me. My viewers, you guys, I think it could happen. A lot of hard work. We'll get there. Chad Baxter. Good morning. Can you get a P.O. box? I'm sure you can get some cool mail in box. I am going to get a P.O. box eventually. Because right now, I don't think I have enough subscribers to warrant me paying for one. But I will. But if you want to send me anything, you can always send it to Lunker's P.O. box and just say two guns of chicken strips or to Jimmy, and I will get it for sure. Fifth question from Just Real Fishing. How'd you get so red-blooded American? Is that how y'all make them down there in the great state of Texas? Why, yes, sir. That is how they make them down here. Good question. Why don't you use a bait caster more? Previous question. That's number six question. Just not comfortable with it. I use what I'm comfortable with, and that's a spinner combo. Future will change. Bait caster action. Number seventh question. Evan Rice. What's your favorite chicken strip so far? And also, are you a ranch, honey mustard, or barbecue sauce type guy? Well, my favorite chicken strip so far is Pie Pies. I love me some Pie Pies. They happen to be on point the night I was reviewing them. But like every other place, they are hit and miss. You get it right time. Remember, I'm judging the chicken strips on overall biscuits, side items, french fries, everything. Everything has to be crisp, fresh, great. So far, Pie Pies hit it, nailed it like a champion. Good question. Number eight from Will Engel. What will your next gun purchase be? Well, this is tough. You know, when I buy a gun, I kind of just have a certain amount of money that I want to spend. I never really choose a certain kind of gun I want to get and go look for it. It's more along the lines of I have so much set amount and I go out and I'm like, that is awesome. But I really have been looking at Benelli M4s lately. They are sweet. So who knows? I come out with an AK, which I've been liking. I come out with a Kimber, a Glock, a Sig. I don't know. And a Benelli M4 is what I'm leaning towards. Jay Browder and Rock Strongo, the winner of the frame signed, actually second and third of that question. There's your answer. Question number nine from Bill Risley. Has Peric ever come on to you? And if so, did you punch him in his lady bits? No, Peric is not gay. He did not come on to me. He's actually a really cool dude. Peric's a good dude. Like him. Good man. Good guy. Real respectful. Real respectful. Like him. Good dude. Question number 11. No, 10 or 11. I don't know. Comes from Michael Myers. Yes, that's his real name. I actually know this guy. His question is, why is the hair on your head blonde and the hair on your chin red? Ha ha. Ha ha. Ha ha. So funny. But not funny. Answer is genetics. I don't know, dude. Why are you balding? Huh? Why are you balding? Why do you look like a 9-year-old in an adult's body? I don't know, punk. Wait till the next time I see you. Mark Werther. Guns and chicken strips. Question number, we're gonna go with 12. Guns and chicken. How many guns do you own? How many guns do you got? It's my birthday, December 4th. Can I please get a happy birthday shout out? Thanks, James. Have a wonderful day. Guess what? Happy birthday, Mark Werthern. I hope you're having a great. You're the man. Keep on rocking, brother. And as for how many guns, I don't really know how many. Quite a few. Okay, number 13. 12 or 13, whatever. White Shadow. How did you and Lunkers meet? Well, my house that we lived in back in the day, we moved into it and all our stuff was in the garage. We all moved in a rush, like 3 a.m., and everything got put in the garage. And then I left and went to a friend's house and got a call from my dad saying that the house was on fire.
Fire!
Came back and literally something caught on fire in the garage where all our stuff was. The garage burned, everything in it burned, so we were just screwed out of luck. The insurance company hooked us up with a rent house 5 blocks away. That rent house happened to be right across the street from Mr. Lunker's grandparents' house. Then he moved down here from Washington in with his grandparents. My brother and him were the same age in the high school. He didn't really get along with a lot of people, neither did we. Boom, homies. just like that. Been hanging out ever since. I even went to visit him in Georgia when he was stationed there. That's how we met. Question number 13 from Vincenzo Swag. Question: is Musa named after Musa Kala in Afghanistan? If that's how you say it, I'm sorry if I didn't say it right. Since I think I remember you saying Rob rescued her while he was deployed. Well, he'd say he, which I understand how you can get confused. Musa is named after Musa, which I've been told is Arabic for Moses. So that's what he's named after, Moses. Arabic for Moses. I don't speak the language. I'm just going off what I've been told. Question number 15. Justin Thanusone. I'm sorry if I butchered. Will you and Rob take a fishing trip anytime soon? I know you watch his house when he's gone. Of course, I always go fishing with Rob when he's in town. Love fishing. I probably will not go out of town, being that I work a full-time job during the week. But yes, we will go fishing soon. Have you ever hated a gun after you purchased it? And what did you do with it then? The only gun I ever disliked after I purchased it was a double barrel 12 gauge short barrel coach gun. And the only reason I had to hate it, I just disliked it. I never hated a gun I bought because I did research before I bought it. The reason I disliked it is because it was messed up to where when I shot it, both barrels went off. And I only shot double X magnums out of it. It hurt the first time I shot it, so I really disliked it. And what I did with it, I just took it to the gunsmith and he hooked it up, fixed it. Next question. I believe it's question 15. I'm so lost on the number right now. It's so late. I got off work late. Been sick. Going loopy. What would you take with you if there's a zombie? From Jared Martin. What would you take with you if there's a zombie apocalypse and you can only take 5 things? Let's see. Tomahawk. Boom. Machete. K-bar machete. Boom. SOCOM 16. Boom. As much ammo as I can carry. Boom. As much food as I can carry. Boom. Question number 16. What kind of group does your SOCOM 16 get at 100 yards? What distance did you zero it at? I don't know what grouping gets at 100 yards. I have not measured out 100 yards with it yet and shot. Farthest I've shot with it so far would be probably 50 yards. And I shot about a silver dollar size group. So I'd say it probably gets a baseball size group at 100 yards. I'm not a precision shooter. If you watch my combat effective video, you'll know that. Combat effective. Question number 16. LOL smiley face tongue out. That's the person it's from. How did you like the cane sauce? It was okay. It was like every other place's secret sauce. Mixture of mayo and ketchup. That's what I'm guessing anyway. Tastes like mayo and ketchup mixed. Love mayo, love ketchup. Would you consider hunting on this channel? Yes, I've actually got some plans, upcoming plans to go hunting. Supposed to go this weekend, but my niece is still in the hospital, and I don't want to leave town while she's in the hospital. But I will be going hunting soon. Promise you that. If not deer, 100% hogs. But hogs and shooting gotta wait till after deer season. Question number 17. Comes from Ian Oliver. If you could go anywhere for vacation, where would you go and what would you do? Honestly, I'm happy right where I am. I'd travel anywhere once, if offered. I really would. I'd love to travel, but I also love being home. I work too much. Think about a vacation. I really don't know. Actually, for vacation, I'd go back down to Demolition Ranch. That'd be awesome. Go hang out with Matt and his family. Amazing family. Very good people. Question number 21. I don't know. We'll go with question number 17. This comes from SROCKM3. Who would win in a fight? Grizzly bear or silverback gorilla? Grizzly bear. Hands down. How long have you been concealed carrying? From Jack Weinrich. Since the day I turned 21. Long as I have been legally able to. Get some!
Question number 22. Jackson York, what are your future goals for this channel?
Future goals? It all just depends, man. My goals for the channel is to grow as much as I can, put as much good content as I can, just do my best to make it as comedic and just positive and good vibes. Good vibes is what it's all about. But as for future goals, just love guns, love hanging out.
I love laughing. Mix all those together, that's what my goals are. Make the channel great. John Walters Outdoors. How come you're at Rob's house when he isn't there? As I watch over his family, his house. Rob's had a lot of stupid people threatening him since he's become a little bit bigger. Just typical. Certain things have happened to where it warrants me being here. William Johnson, do you smoke marijuana? No, I do not. Any trips or big... Corey Harrison, any trips or big events planned? Like I said, hunting, hog hunting as soon as deer season's over. I believe deer season's over January 4th. Rifle season or something. I'm not sure exactly, but yes, hunting, hog hunting as soon as deer season's over. Shooting as soon as deer season's over. Blickety black blackout. And I cannot wait. Stick around. It's going to be great. 22. Lachlan Mangione from Australia. I'm an exchange student in Spain right now and think your videos are awesome. Thank you, my brother. My question is, what is your opinion on Australian animals and would you ever go there? Yes, 100%. Love to go to Australia. Love the way it looks. Australian animals, I've always said I want to get a kangaroo. And I actually saw some when I was in East Texas the other day. So, kangaroo action. I'm told I have to get a, what are they called? Joey. Yeah, I think that's what it's called. Not a red kangaroo, because they fight and get like 6 feet tall. And I don't know if I want a 6 foot tall animal walking around my house. Get in that kitchen and make me some blueberry pancakes. So yes, I love Australian animals. John Roden. Kane is good, but it's... Philip Snodgrass. Jimmy, first off, have a beautiful day. Question, when you go into the Chinese restaurants, they have that place map, animal sign to date of birth. What one are you? I am whichever one June falls into. Mason Slaughter. What, in your opinion, is the best deer hunting round caliber? I prefer 308. Just an all-around great round. 100% agree with you. Love 308 rounds. Champion status. 308 all day, baby. This question comes from Jay Quinn. On balancing your full-time job and being a YouTuber, and thirdly, who inspired you to be a YouTuber, and fourthly, Nam Dun, you're awesome, by the way, and doing a voiceover with Musa was cinematic genius. Why, thank you, sir. You're a good man. And who inspired me, like I said in the previous question, Rob. Rob's a man, inspired me. Appreciate it, Rob. How I balance? I don't. I sleep like 1-2 hours a night, editing until, I'm up editing until sometimes midnight, 1 o'clock. I have to be up at 2:30, 3 o'clock to get to Dallas by 4:30. That's how I balance it. I don't. Ian Praw, if you could have any type of weapon, gun, or sword, what would it be? Dream gun. Ma Deuce. Brandon Gilbick, was Musa ever aggressive towards you? No, he was not, because I know he hates strangers. If he was, how long did it take for him to get used to you? I met him as a puppy, so he never was aggressive towards me, and he hates everyone else. He doesn't know you, you're going to get bit, plain and simple. First gun ever was a gold single-action 22 cowboy revolver. It was awesome. Family heirloom. Fortunately, it got sold when we were younger. Good reason, though. Needed money. No, I didn't sell it. My dad did. We needed it, though. What is a good budget? Comes from Will Stokes. What is a good budget AR-15? I'm not really sure. I don't have much experience with budget ones, but my first AR-15 was an Olympic Arms AR. That thing, I put thousands of rounds through it. Formed like a champion. It was only $700. Philip Blevins, what kind of gun should I get? Well, if you're looking to get a gun, go to the store, try them all out. Hold them, feel them, best feel. That's the gun you're most comfortable with. That's the gun you buy. Colton Brodeur, who is your favorite comedian? Dan Cummins, the man. Funny actor? Jim Carrey, why not?
VeggieClean, aisle 5. I repeat, price check on VeggieClean, aisle 5. That's VeggieClean. We got a customer down here with a full-on fallopian fungus. She's baking a loaf of bread, and I think it's sourdough. Put a rush on that.
Jacob Nofsinger, what is your favorite kind of dog? Catahoula Leopard. What is your favorite chicken strip joint? Pies. James Farmer, 308 or 6.5 Creedmoor for new Savage bolt action rifle. 308. Matt Krupe, if you had to choose only one sauce for your chicken strips, would it be honey mustard or ketchup? Honey mustard, foo, all day, baby. Buck you, 102. How many states have you been to? Please name them. I've been to a lot. I'm not going to name them all. Blaine Weber, do you have any interest in shotguns, or are you just a rifle pistol guy? I love shotguns. Started off with shotguns. My nickname growing up was Shoddy, so shotguns. Love them. What are you going to do with rubber band ball at Demo Ranch? You're going to have to wait and find out when you go there, Mr. J. Browder. Buckslayer, will you see how many junior bacon cheeseburgers you could eat or go to Arby's and order two meat mountains? I watched my brother eat 9 junior bacon cheese one time after a long night of drinking. That, my friend, is impressive. I'm pretty sure I've either beat that or tied it. But no, I will not, because as I'm getting older, I've noticed that when I get stuffed, it doesn't feel good. I've been trying not to stuff myself and watch my amount I'm eating. Not as much as calories, as you obviously know. I don't watch that. Yeah. But amount, no, I probably won't be doing that. But thank you for the suggestion. Bailey Tanner, how much do you hate your high point? I've never owned a high point, considering I knew that they were crap beforehand, so I never bought one. Evan Nesselrodit. Question. If I asked you to come to Del Rio, Texas and come bow fishing, would you? 100% would if I had the time off. And in the future, if I am not doing my day job and YouTubing, 100% will be there, my brother. Hit me up on Instagram. You can see them in the link description. Bow fishing? Love it. Always want to do it. I have a bow fishing rig, actually. Just never used it. Felix Blotch, can I declare you my spirit animal? I guess, but I'm not an animal. Sure. Lord J. Gooptail, what is your all-time favorite band and your go-to song? Don't have a favorite band. Don't really have a go-to song. It changes all the time, man. Right now it's Jason Derulo. I want you to want me. Too hard to sleep, got the knees on the floor, nothing on me. And I can't take it no more, it's gone degrees. Luke B. Basson, what was your first job? My first job was a plumbing apprentice. That for about 2 years. Desert Yeti, the question is for you. You could own, shoot a firearm, past or present. What would it be? Good one. Not too sure. Ma Deuce, I'd like to own and shoot one. Ma Deuce, M338 MRAD. Do you reload? No, but I have before. My grandpa does. Andrew Miller, what's your favorite movie of all time? Forrest Gump. The show. Big Tom Hanks fan right here. Not so much the Pyramid Mason BS. Saving Private Ryan, Forrest Gump, baby. When I went to Georgia to visit Rob from Mr. Turkla from Lunkers TV, Robert Garcia, good question. Since you've met Mr. Demolition Ranch, Matt, what would you rate Matt in the scale of coolness when you guys are behind camera? Matt Carricker, Demolition Ranch, 100% great guy. Exactly who you see on the screen. He is the man. Such a great guy. Great dad, great father, great husband. Exactly who you see in the videos. There's one genuine dude right there. When we were down there, nothing but courtesy, nothing but respect, everything about him. Good homegrown Texas dude, 100% genuine guy. Best 1911 for the money, I'm going with Kimber. Ryan Koch, why is Rob's nickname Drew? Middle name's Andrew. Called him Drew in high school. Mr. Klaudowitz, any food or ingredients you really dislike? Onions. Don't like onions. Not a fan. Michael O'Brien, are you a Cowboys fan? America's team, son? Yes, sir. Plus, grew up in DFW. Yeah. Cowboys all day, baby. My grandma actually had a room in her house called the Cowboys Room. And I actually have pretty much a signed picture from every famous cowboy that ever played, including Roger Staubach, Troy Aikman, Emmitt Smith. The Cowboys win the Super Bowl, mark my words. There will be multiple Cowboys signed picture giveaways. Well, it looks like I went through all of them. And I just wanted to hit a point real quick. I skipped all the ones that were asking me what my day job is. One, I would love to tell y'all, and I will one day, as that I'm still doing that job. I have been told multiple times by higher-ups, do not mention what I do for a living on any form of social media. I've seen other people get fired from it, so I'm not going to mention what I do for a living. I apologize. Sincerely, I eventually will tell you guys, but as of right now, while I'm still doing this job, I cannot mention what I do for a living. Sincerely, I apologize, but I cannot afford to lose that job right now. Sorry about that. Gotta eat. We get them views up. We get them subscribers up. I'll let you know. Like I said, in the future, we'll let you know, but right now, cannot. Sorry. Looks like I got through all them. Again, sorry, I can't tell you what I do for a living. Will eventually. 100%. Big shout out to all you viewers, man. Every day I read y'all's comments. Trust me, I read them all. I take them all to heart. Y'all just amaze me. Y'all are some good people. I don't see anything but positivity in there. And that's what I like. That's what I strive for. Stay positive. Live life. Love it. Live it to the fullest. Love your friends. Love your family. Treat everybody like champions. I hope I answered all your questions. If you have any more questions, put it in the comments. I'll do my best to answer them. I'll reply on the comments. I hope you enjoyed this episode. Sorry if it was so long, but I would have felt bad if I didn't get to all the comments and all the questions. So if I skipped you, let me know, and I will answer you right back in the comments. Appreciate everything y'all have done for me and Rob and his family. And as always, I hope you all enjoyed this episode. As always, we'll see you tomorrow.